Hey guys, this is John. I'm going to introduce you guys to the future of bass fishing.
Hi, I'm Cora, and welcome to Greenfish Nation.
Guys, today Cora and I are going to be doing a little video for you guys. She wanted to come out and throw a wacky rig around today. This is not something that she's done very much. Have you ever thrown a wacky rig? Okay, so she's never thrown a wacky rig. So our goal today is to try to catch some fish on a wacky rig. So you guys stay tuned to Greenfish Nation for some action on a wacky rig here at the Honey Hole. Of course, so what we're going to do on this wacky rig is it's not as fast as fishing a stick bait, just twitching a stick bait. We're going to cast it out, you're going to let it fall, and you got to be a line watcher, okay? So you're going to watch your line. If you feel a nibble, you got to reel down and set the hook, okay? All right, let's get after it. That's all right, just work it back on the bank. Remember, just work it right to the edge of that moss. Come on back some more. Right to the edge. All right, let it drop and just, you let it drop and then every once in a while just twitch it up, you know, twitch it just like you would a Texas rig worm. Bring it on out to the outside of that grass. Right there. Now let it fall. Remember, this is weightless. It don't have any weight on it other than just the hook, okay? All right, you need to tighten your line up a little bit. You want to reel it and then just twitch it a couple times. Hey, look at all them baby bass right there. I know you guys can't see it, but there's a ton of little fry right there. Just twitch it and twitch your, hold your rod down just a little bit. All right, now reel your line up. Now give it a couple twitches. Let it fall. Gotta be a line watcher. Okay, watch right where your line goes in the water. And if that thing starts moving to one side or the other, sometimes these fish will pick that thing up and you won't even know it. Guys, we're throwing a Strike King Ocho in Cora's favorite color. It's sweet potato pie. It's a 5-inch and it's rigged up on a weedless Strike King weedless hook. Set the hook. Oh, broke her line off, guys. Did y'all see that? Good thing we brought more hooks. Y'all stay tuned. All right, guys, I know y'all didn't see that, but Cora literally had one break her off right here 6 inches from the bank. She don't fish with me a whole lot, maybe 4 or 5 times a year just because she's a kid and she gets bored easy, but that brings up a good point. When you're teaching the future of bass fishing, you need to be patient with them. Don't be out there griping and, you know, carrying on about them getting tangled up. Their kids are going to get tangled up, you know. Really what I try to do, if you notice, I don't even have a rod and reel with me. I made this trip all about her. We stopped at the store, we got some snacks. I'm letting her learn a new technique that she asked to learn, a wacky rig, because she knows I like to fish it. And obviously that was her first cast and she got broke off on it. You just gotta make it all about the kids, guys. So she's going to get some hooks and she's gonna learn to throw a new rod and reel today. She just don't know it. I brought a underspin. It's totally new to her, so she'll have a learning curve with that and maybe catch a few fish and have a good experience learning this underspin and catching fish on a wacky rig that she's learning. So you guys hang in there. All right, guys, so I'm going to put her Ocho on this little underspin. Got it in some pocket somewhere. That's the scales in case we catch a big one. All right, guys, so Cora has never in her life had one of these rod and reels in her hand, unless she was handing it to Dad out of the rod box of the boat, so I'm gonna be patient with her. Y'all be patient with her. Stick around, let's see how she does. All right, Cora, this is real easy, okay? So you're gonna roll that up to about 6 inches, just like you normally would. And then you gotta have this hand turn that to the top, okay? See how Dad's picking that up with his finger? And you flip that bell open, and literally, look, you just flip it with your wrist, okay? And then you have to close this with your fingers, okay? And then it reels the same way as yours. And you'll just twitch it, just like that, okay? So just twitch that in and get used to the reeling part of it. Hold it, look here. Hold right there like that. Just reel and twitch. Slow it down. Now this reel is a lot faster than your reel, so you don't have to reel it near as much, okay? Mm-hmm. There you go, just work it up through there. All right, there you go. There you are, guys. What do y'all think? Well, let's don't reel it all the way up to the pole, okay? Mm-hmm. There you go. All right, Cora Gale got her first cast with a underspin on a wacky rig, and she got her first fish. Here you go. Hold it up there and show the camera. Go over and show the folks at Greenfish Nation what you caught. There you go. What do you think about that?
It's good.
Yep. All right. Put him back respectfully. There you go. Good job, kid. All right, remember Dad said to put it about 6 inches and make sure that the string's close to the top. Remember how I showed you to hold it with two fingers above? All right, now what you're gonna do is you're gonna reach down here with this finger. You're gonna get your line. Now don't, look, you just wanna put it right on the tip, okay? All right, you got it? And flip your bell open. All right, and you're just gonna use your wrist. Just give it a cast. There you go. Now flip your bail. If you reel it like that, you're gonna cause your line to get all twisted up. Now just work it. All right, guys, look here. Another fish on the Oco, on the underspin with a wacky rig. That's good enough. Swing it over here, Dad'll get it off for you. I know she knows how to take fish off, so this ain't a taking off fish lesson. This is more of a how to use the wacky rig and the underspin rod, so I'm gonna take her fish off just to expedite this video. All right, there you go. All right, guys, Cora has decided she wants to go back to her rod and reel. She's been exposed to the underspin a little bit. She kind of gets the basic mechanics of it. Just throw your worm off. Got a fish on it? Believe you do. Remember when we got broke off again, guys? That was a pretty good fish too. This thing's only got like 4 pound test on it, so listen to me. When they start pulling drag, you can't just keep cranking on them because you're gonna twist your line up. Okay? Y'all hang tight. Well, you gotta learn to play your fish a little bit too. You can't just horse them in. You know what I mean? Use your drag, tire them out a little bit. So, Corey, you're gonna have to play these fish a little bit, okay, with this line. You can't just horse them in like you do with Dad's big rods, okay? Because you've got this small line on there. I think that fish hit that thing as soon as it hit the water. And just cast it out there easy. You don't have to try to throw it across the pond, okay? It's only 20 yards across there. Reel it up. Let me see you drag. So when it starts doing that, quit reeling, okay? Keep pressure on it, but quit reeling. And when it quits, as soon as it quits clicking, you reel, okay? All right, get after it. We're gonna learn how to play fish, guys. There you go. Remember, we're gonna play these fish. We're going to hook them, and then if they start taking drag, we're going to let them have it either to the right or to the left. Okay? There you go. So do you feel more comfortable twitching it to the right? Turn your body a half a turn. There you go. There you go. That way you're not just facing it dead on. You know what I mean? Now listen, don't break off that hook because that's the last one we got. All right, there we go. Had a little lettuce on it there. Here you go. All right, we're going to try to cast it right out there in the middle, okay? Hang on, it's twisted up on the end. All right. So we've caught two fish. There you go. That's a beautiful cast. Caught two fish and been broke off twice. All right, hold your rod up. Hold your rod up. Hold it up. There you go. You're doing great. You have to keep pressure on him, okay? There you go. Just keep steady pressure on him, and as long as he ain't taking drag, you're reeling, okay? He starts taking drag. Look at that little old thing. He looks like a cigar. All right, stop reeling. Pick him up. There you go. That was an excellent job. You done great. He started taking drag. You quit reeling, didn't tangle your line all up. Caught him right in the top of the mouth. Man, I tell you what, guys, it just don't get much better than that right there. What do you think, Corgail?
Mm-hmm.
All right, let's get another one. Just make a nice, easy lobbing cast, just like you was lobbing a baseball. Rod should stop about right here, right? Okay. You make a good cast this time. Perfect. Awesome cast. All right, be a line watcher. About to get you another one, ain't you? You're doing a great job. Dad's got cleanup duty and fish taking off duty today. Yep, little bass, ain't they? Make your cast over there and that stuff over there. See if you can get over there and get in one of them's face. There you go, let it drop right there. All right, cast it. Cast it toward that tree right over and leave your rod about right there when you cast it. Okay? You got this, girl. Work that back. Yeah, you, remember you push the button and hold it down. Thought you had a bite, huh? Thought you did too for a second. All right, bring it on in. All right, guys, we're gonna move around to the pond to another spot, so you guys stay tuned. Main thing, guys, here is just to make sure that, first of all, she catches some fish and has a good time. If she can learn a little bit along the way, then that's a bonus. All right, sister girl, get right out there on that point and make your cast across that point. Is it tangled up?
No.
Here, walk right up to the water's edge. That's why I got them water shoes on.
I don't wanna...
You're not. Go ahead. Perfect. Look at you. You're already learning, making that correction where you'll just twitch it one way. Work it a little bit slower. You're moving a little too fast. There you go. All right, there you go, right there. You're trying to make that thing act like it's a worm just crawling along the bottom, okay? Instead of twitching it, raise it up and let it down. There you go. Raise it up, reel it down. I think you got a bite. You might want to set the hook, jerk it. I don't think you need to now. You already got the fish on. Remember how to set the hook? You jerk up on it. Well, good Lord. He came off. He spit it out. Yep, here. All right, you're good to go. You okay?
Mm-hmm.
Get a little water in your eye. All right, when you set that hook, remember to jerk up on it. There you go. That's a good spot right across there. Don't raise up so much. Remember, it's this much, not this much, okay? You're doing good. Do you have a fish on there? Because your line's going way down that way. It might have just been the wind blowing it. All right, let's get that stuff off. You about done? Well, we can go if you're ready. Make one more cast and see if you can get one more fish, and then we'll call it a day. Oh, that's a great cast. Work that thing back nice and slow. Good Lord, you hear that bass over there? Something gun there sound like it weighed 20 pounds. What are you gonna do if you hook into one like that? Set the hook, there you go. Remember, if it's taking drag, you're not reeling. Reel, you got to keep tension on it, baby. You got to keep tension on it. Move around them weeds and get it out of the weeds. Keep tension on it. Reel it up, reel it up, reel it up. That's awesome. Look at you go.
He's different looking.
I'm going to start calling you Bill Dance or Jimmy Houston. Oh,
sharpies.
These?
Yeah.
Yeah, so they lay down like that.
Didn't know that.
And then when you go forward, they stand up, see?
They look like
they're not sharp. They're sharp, but they're not like terrible. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. What that does is that keeps other fish from eating him from the back. That way they got to eat him head first, see?
You ate my bait.
Yeah, we'll get you another one. Okay. I got some more in my pocket. He's a twitcher and a reeler. You don't have to let it sink, twitch and reel. Now you're twitching at 6 inches where you need to be twitching at 2 foot like you was. Different presentation, you know what I mean? You got one? All right, reel it on up. There you go. All right, make a cast. Walk on up that way. You got a fish, don't you? Or not? I believe you got a fish, don't you? Walk up that way, Cor, instead of pulling him through all them weeds. Get into an open spot. There you go. Man, look at that thing jump. Look at you go. All right. Y'all don't know it, but this girl right here has been known to catch two fish on the same crankbait at the same time. All right, Corey, you about ready to call it a day?
Yep.
All right, there you go. Get a good hold on him. He's going to flop.
Uh-huh.
All right, go ahead. Give him a little pitch out there. There you go. All right, guys, I want to thank you for joining the channel today. And, Cora, what'd you learn today, Cora?
I learned how to fish your fishing rod.
The underspin?
Yeah.
Yep, so you got a little exposure to it, right?
Mm-hmm.
Caught a few fish, broke off a couple times. That happens. So would you do anything different?
Maybe get a new line.
To get a new line, okay. Did you learn how to play a fish?
Yes.
All right, so we did learn something. We had a good time. That's the most important thing. Until next time, guys, I'm John, and this is Cora. We're with Greenfish Nation. We want to wish all of you tight lines.